Welcome to the Ship Traffic Impact on Air Quality Challenge. Just like roads and air travel routes, ships follow particular shipping lanes when traveling from continent to continent. And so NASA and ESA air quality satellites have been able to capture some of the emissions from these thousands of ships traveling around the world each day. There are several different websites you can go to see where particular ships are traveling on any given day. Here's one of them. Here's another one. And there are several others as well. And so if you're trying to look for a particular date or you want to look for interesting places to look for the signal of ship traffic on air pollution, these sites will be quite helpful. It is more difficult to see air pollution over the water than it is over land, simply because the water is darker and absorbs more sunlight, so less is reflected back to space. Also, sometimes the ship traffic or shipping lane is near a continent, and so some of the pollution from the continent will also get mixed in. And so this is a subtle signal compared to some of the other signals, like a large city. But with careful analysis, the shipping signals can be seen. So I encourage you to look at some of the support documents that I'm providing links to here. Here's a map I made with Giovanni, and what I did was I saturated the scale a little bit, and so the upper end of the scale, and so you can see ships traveling here and here as well. So it's going to be a little bit more difficult, but interesting challenge. Also shown here is the surface NO2 concentration retrieved from a NASA model. And so this is publicly available. This will show you on a particular day where the model predicts there to be a signal for the various ship traffic. And this is for NO2. And this is from sulfur dioxide, SO2. And so ships emit both nitrogen dioxide and sulfur dioxide. The sulfur is in the fuel, and the nitrogen is in the air, and when it's combusted in a diesel engine, it generates lots of NO2. And so these signals are, you can see here the shipping signal is kind of merging in with the signal from the continents. European scientists recently published a very novel publication describing how they, using tropomy, the really fine resolution data coming from tropomy, to detect pollution from individual ships. And so here's a story about that publication that goes into more detail about how they did it. And if you want to go to the original publication, here it is. And this has all the technical details about how they were able to detect pollution from individual ships. So previous to this publication, people had to do monthly or average for a whole season or average for a year. And so all are useful, but if you can detect an individual ship, then you can get a better idea of different types of ships having different amounts of pollution. We can only see the really large ships with only looking at one day of data, but still it's quite useful. Here's a useful link that shows you how to get data, how to visualize it, and if you go further down in this story, it'll give you links to different NASA resources. What's nice is the NASA data archive also includes all the tropomy data, but the European Space Agency also has some nice sites on that allow you to visualize the tropomy NO2 and SO2 data. And finally, here's another really useful tool. This is an ESA Sentinel browser called the EO browser. And the link is right there. It's really easy to plot. You just want to click on Sentinel 5P, and then you can see the SO2 and the NO2 data there. I'm just showing the most recent image of Rome, and you can see how the city of Rome stands out nicely. But this is another interesting tool that might be useful for you. So this has been a brief overview of how you can use satellites to see ship traffic and their impact on air quality. I wish you the best of luck.